Hi there, Surinder, Sandhu here, Bedford Chiropractic Clinic. Today I just want to talk to you a little bit about sort of immunity. What is immunity and what you can do about it? But what I really want to do is I want to just obviously pay full credit to a gentleman on YouTube called Dr. Eric Berg, because I've basically just literally taken this information from him. Okay, I'm not a researcher, I am a seeker of knowledge, and I'm very practical. So most of the information that I'll be giving you will be curated, which means that I've collected it from things that I've read, things that I've heard, and obviously sort of YouTube is a resource that I use quite heavily as well. So I'm giving full respect, and the information here is from Dr. Eric Berg. Okay, so let's talk about immunity. And most importantly, let's talk about sort of how you can bulletproof your immunity, because guys, you know, this is something that's so important, because right now there is something out there that is attacking us. Yeah, this unseen enemy that is around us. And what we need to do is we need to sort of put the shutters up. Right, we need to make sure that we are protecting ourselves in the best possible way that we can. So just a very, very sort of brief summary of immunity. Well, immunity is basically your army, right? It's your army. And it basically protects you against disease. It comes from a Latin called immunus, which basically means sort of protecting your house. So something to that effect, yeah? But what it basically the immune system does is it's basically your immigration. It's your barrier. It's your barrier against the sort of what might be trying to invade you. And there are things trying to invade us all the time. Because all around us, there are incredible amount of pathogens, bacteria, fungus, viruses that are continually trying to sort of get into us because we are their host. So the barriers that we have, of course, is the skin, and the skin is covered with lots and lots of sort of good bacteria, which sort of give us a shield. Which is why it's important, guys, you know, to sort of not to over clean. But obviously, at this moment, it is important to wash your hands, and obviously, you know, you must abide by that. So the skin is very important, and that's one of the reasons why, guys, you know, I'm very particular about what I put in my skin, because I want to look after my skin. The skin is the largest sort of excretory organ as well, but it also is our biggest protection barrier. So I generally don't tend to use sort of any harsh creams or harsh sort of chemicals on my skin. I tend to use a very, very gentle sort of body wash, and I'll also use coconut oil as my moisturizer. Okay, coconut oil is my moisturizer, but that's for another time. Now, your mucus lining. Your mucus linings are basically another entry point as well for the invaders, but they're also sort of where there is some protection offered as well, because they have a layer of mucus which sort of the actual sort of invader has to go through, and that is also protecting you as well. So it's really important to obviously make sure that they are sort of looked after, and you do that through nutrition. Obviously, inflammation. Now, inflammation can work both ways. Inflammation in short sort of periods when we need it, right, is exceptionally good, because the body is attacking whatever is sort of causing that that problem, and for the inflammation to sort of is there to help your body to heal. But chronic inflammation is a completely different story. Chronic inflammation is very damaging and can cause the body a lot more harm, just purely because the body becomes insensitive to the chemicals that help to sort of help you on the inflammation side. Now, part of the inflammation is white blood cells and, of course, plasma cells. Plasma cells are normally the first sort of cells that get in contact with an invader, and then they sort of will respond by sort of activating the white blood cells and activating sort of your attack system. Also, we mustn't ignore the 3 kilograms, the 3 kilograms of microflora, the fungus, bacteria that are living in your guts, which should be living in your guts, because there is so much research out there now that it's called the microbiome, and the research now is telling us that sort of our genes are actually augmented by the genes in the gut flora, but also they will break down bile, they'll help you to sort of produce vitamin K, and also what they do is they protect you against bad mental barrier, fungus, I keep calling it fungus, bacteria, because as they're lining the wall of the gut system, they're reducing the amount of space that's available to the invaders. So you need to have good flora. And one of the things that you really want to be looking at is probiotics. And one of the things I'm going to talk to you about is sauerkraut. Sauerkraut is such a good product to be taking for that. Okay, so what is this defense system? So how does it actually work? So very simply, what you do is it makes acid. So you have some pH 2 in your stomach. So obviously that's important. But please understand that that sort of acid can be affected by the way that you think, by your thoughts, because your thoughts are so powerful, you know, and that's why negative thoughts will produce a cascade of chemicals that will dampen you, and that's where stress sort of is such a big problem, because what it's doing is it's dampening your defense system. So one of the things that you really want to do is you are now sort of pushed into an environment where you are with your loved ones. And of course, loved ones can mean that sometimes, you know, sort of things don't always go the way that you would like them to, and stress can be up a little bit. So try to sort of be understanding of each other. Be understanding of each other and keep your stress levels low. Also, the immune system will secrete poisons to actually sort of kill whatever the invader is. This also produces free radicals. It produces hydrogen peroxide as well, which sort of causes oxidation. Creates enzymes to sort of try and kill that invader. And also, it obviously sort of offers more competition, so it's trying to compete against that invader to stop it from sort of taking up sort of food, using up space in your body. Obviously, we spoke about mucus and inflammation and how they are going to be there to protect you as well. Now, what the immune system does is it also builds a memory as well. In particular, the killer cells and the T cells, they're going to build a memory. And what they're going to do is they're going to then recognize that invader again. So if it ever comes back, then it will sort of produce an immune response much, much quicker. Which is why it's so important, right, that... I mean, at this moment, yes, we have to keep our surfaces clean. We have to sort of keep washing our hands. But we are making our environment so sterile. Before this attack, you know, we sort of are so obsessive about cleaning our children's faces, cleaning their hands, you know, so obsessive about cleaning our surfaces. And what we're doing is we're not giving our body a chance to sort of have these bacteria and these viruses that we can then build an immune defense system out. And I really worry about sort of our children and our great-great-great-grandchildren, because if this sort of this sort of necessity to keep cleaning all the time. Now, please understand, I understand the situation at the moment, and do not ignore the advice about cleaning your hands and keeping your surfaces clean. Right? I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that as a norm, we have become a very clean, obsessive society. And has it helped us? You know, let's face it, has it helped us? So, I remember the days when I was a child and I was allowed to sort of run around in the garden, as many of you, sort of my generation, will remember. You know, we used to run around the garden, we used to get our hands dirty, I remember eating mud, eating rocks and stuff. And, it hasn't done me any harm. I've got a robust immune system. So, I'm just saying that, okay? So, take it on board as you wish. But at the moment, please abide by the instructions to wash your hands. Okay, so we build a memory, right? And it's important to sort of have that memory, because then, of course, the immune response is much better. Now, the phagocytes are one of these sort of cells that sort of, they're basically like the Pac-Man, right, of your immune system. They will go around and they'll sort of ingest and break down and kill sort of the invaders. And we need them. We need them to be active. We need them to be working. Unfortunately, in some autoimmune conditions, you know, they can also start attacking our body as well. So that's not always ideal. Now, apple cider vinegar is something that's really useful. And some of you who watched my video this morning, which is still, I think, available on Facebook, but we are going to put it on a YouTube channel as well, right? I spoke about apple cider vinegar because it's one of the things that I add to my drinks, apple cider vinegar. I add about a couple of tablespoons because I want my body to be slightly acidic. in this case, right, because phagocytes work better in an acidic environment. They work better in an acidic environment. And in 1 liter of blood, there should be about 6 billion of them. Okay, now what about the pathogen? So what's their response? How are they dealing with it, with our body's defenses? Well, what they do is they block vitamin D. So vitamin D is a hormone. It's a sort of a hormone. It's not just a pure, simple vitamin. And one of the things is it's a modulator. It actually controls your immune system. So one of the things I'm going to go into next is what can you do? One of the things is you need to take vitamin D. Now, if you can't get hold of really good quality vitamin D, then and vitamin D is a fat-soluble vitamin. So it needs to be in a fat source. It needs to be emulsified in a fat. Tablets and whatever, I don't know the efficacy of those. And K2 is important. Now, K2 is important if you want to have synthesis in bone, but we're not talking about bone here, right? Bone protection. We're talking about the immune system and how vitamin D can help that. Okay, so that's important to make sure that you get enough vitamin D. The sun is shining at the moment, so get out into the sun, but don't rely on the sun giving you enough vitamin D. And if you are in the sun, you need to expose your skin to it. You need to expose your skin about 15 minutes at a time. Obviously, I'm not saying don't protect yourself, right? But 15 minutes at a time. And you know, slathering all these sun creams on your body, that's not really going to help. So expose your skin, bare skin, right, to 15 minutes at a time. And is that going to help you to get enough vitamin D? I don't know. The answer to that, I don't know. Because there is no guarantee that the melatonin in your skin is going to convert to vitamin D, all right? So, but it's a good thing to do, be out in the sun, but take a good source of vitamin D. So where else can you get it from? Yolks, egg yolks, right? Don't ignore egg yolks. Egg yolks have been blamed for being high in cholesterol. Well, cholesterol is actually good for you. A certain amount of cholesterol is good for you, and I'll be talking about that because fats are so important. So cholesterol is actually an anti-inflammatory, so it's important to take egg yolks, yeah? And also, the other thing is cod liver oil is another good source of vitamin D. So those are really good sources. So what the actual invader can do, it can actually mimic your body as well. So you can mimic your cells. And unfortunately, what the virus does, now guys, remember the virus is a dead, inert, I'm call it organism, but it's not really, I wouldn't call it an organism. It's a dead sort of, it's a dead cell, right? It's just a protein, coated protein with these protein sort of appendages, and inside is the RNA and DNA. It's not live. It's not going to be crawling all over you. The only way you're going to get it in you is if you put into your mouth, into your nose, into your eyes, where it can then go into your sort of cell membranes and go into your lining and go into your body, and then start attacking your cells. And what it will do then is it will attack your cells. If the cell accepts it, it has to have that receptor on the cell, and then that DNA and RNA will go into that cell and mimic it, and it will just keep repeating itself again and again until, of course, our immune system comes and fights it and gets rid of it. It also, so what happens is these days they found that the invader can coat itself in an igloo of calcium, and that then means that the immune system can't recognize it, they can't get through it. And that is one of the problems with sort of the fact that we're using sort of too many of these sort of prescriptive drugs, which are just not giving us enough sort of protection anymore, because the bacteria and viruses are getting used to it and they're beginning to protect themselves against it. So it also keeps moving into different joints. It goes through the sanguine fluid, so it can move as well, which obviously makes it difficult for the immune system to sort of keep attacking it all the time. And of course, when it attacks it, it can obviously attack your joints as well, which can be a big problem. It also sort of morphs into different sort of structures as well. Now you have to excuse the writing here. The writing is brilliant, okay? But I'm not. I'm a doctor of chiropractic. I'm not a writer. Okay, so I'm just going to rub this off here. I'm just going to now talk a little bit about, okay, so what is it that I can do? What can I do to help myself? Now, the biggest sort of problem that the world experienced, where over sort of 10 million or so people died last time that we had a disease that spread around the world, was the Spanish flu. The Spanish flu. Now, the interesting enough, the Spanish flu sort of came in 1918. And what was happening around that time? Well, we had the First World War. We had the First World War, and people were nutritionally deficient. You know, I mean, our soldiers were under a lot of stress. The whole world was under stress. And stress is such a major factor in lowering your immune system. It's so, so important to sort of trying to keep keep our enthusiasm, to keep helping each other, to sort of stay positive in these, seriously, you know, dire times. You know, I'm not making this a small thing. You know, I totally understand, you know, sort of how difficult this time is at the moment. But guys, you know, being stressed about it, being worried about it, you know, sort of not encouraging each other, not helping each other, you know, to stay positive is not going to help any of us. So, in 1918, the First World War was happening. It was coming to an end, thankfully, but the people were weak. They were weak in nutritionally. They weren't able to eat sort of green leafy vegetables. They weren't able to have fresh fruit and vegetables. So fresh fruit and vegetables are really, really important at this time, okay? And I know that we've got children in the house, and it's so easy just to sort of give them, you know, prepared foods, to give them processed foods, because they're quick and easy, and I totally understand that. But please, please, try and give them some sort of fresh fruit and vegetables as well, especially vegetables. Not so much fruit, but more vegetables. Try and sort of get them, encourage them to sort of have that. I went this morning to... one journey that I made to go and get some fresh fruit and vegetables, and I went to a farm shop in Southfield in Broome, and luckily they were well stocked, so I really stocked up on my sort of fresh vegetables. And so we need to do that. We need to make sure that our vitamins, our trace minerals, our amino acids, good quality sort of proteins. And most importantly, please don't ignore this, fats. Do not ignore your fats. I don't mean vegetable oils, all right? I mean good quality fat. I mean good quality fat in the sense of coconut oil, in the sense of olive oil, but good quality olive oil. We need to keep our fat content up, because every single cell of our body is a biphospholipid layer, which means there's two layers of fat. And we want that fat structure to be there, which is why cholesterol is so important. So egg yolk is important at the moment, right? Because if that fat layer is intact, then obviously that's another barrier to the virus. So we want to sort of make sure that we're having good quality fats. And by doing that, right, what we're going to do is we're going to sort of again help our immune system to protect itself. And by protecting those fat layers, we're going to help again. To sort of keep that invader away. Now, stress, as I mentioned, stress is a huge dampener, right, to the whole immune system. So really, really work on that, guys. Keep everybody's spirits up. Watch funny movies. Netflix is going crazy out there at the moment, yeah? Sort of Amazon Prime's going crazy. But watch funny movies. Laugh with each other, you know, make jokes, you know, do funny things. Just enjoy the time that you have together. Make the most of it. Because by getting those endorphins working, right, we are improving our immune system. So that's a wonderful thing to do. So stay happy. As difficult as you might think it is, yeah? Now, sleep is very important. Please, you know, don't stay up sort of too late watching movies. You know, I know we think it's a great holiday at the moment, right? And so some kids, you know, think it's wonderful. But keep them to that routine. Keep them to the routine of sleep. Sleep has been shown to be so, so important, right, in keeping your immune system up. Sleep is the main problem with how people age badly. The immune system is completely depressed down with lack of sleep. So there's so many studies out there, so make sure that everyone is getting enough sleep. The other thing that we want to make sure is stop having too much sugar. Sugar feeds viruses, feeds bacteria, feeds fungus. So try to stay off sweets or syrupy things. You know, keep your sugar content down. And I don't mean just the white stuff. What I'm talking about is sort of processed foods, because processed foods have so much hidden sugar in them and salt. You know, look at sort of breads, potatoes, you know, what is mainly sort of our stock foods. please, you know, don't sort of don't have too many of those. So what can you do about it? Well, one of the things that you want to do is you want to make sure that you're taking vitamin C. Now, vitamin C, but not just sort of ascorbic acid, all right, which if that's all you can get, please take it. But vitamin C, what vitamin C does is it stimulates sort of the white blood cells. So it's a really, really good thing to take. Yeah. Also, vitamin D, as I mentioned. So vitamin D, as I mentioned, is a modulator, right, for your immune system. It helps your immune system to control itself. It also sort of stimulates, you know, your T cells. It stimulates the T cells at the thymus gland, because the thymus gland is where these cells learn, right? It's their school. It's where they learn to protect you. So, you know, it's really important to take vitamin D as well. Now, vitamin A is really important for protecting sort of your epithelial cells, you know, protecting your sinuses, protecting your mucus secreting glands. So vitamin A is really, really important. And vitamin A in cod liver oil and green leafy vegetables, right? So look at that. It's for your structural integrity. And also sort of helps the white cells to sort of improve as well. Now zinc is another important one. Now zinc is a very, very important mineral. It's actually used in over sort of 200 plus different sort of chemicals and pathways that are going through your body. So zinc is really important. So, you know, if you're ordering stuff off Amazon, you know, please have a look. We're going to add some links on here of the vitamins that I'm going to recommend, right? The zinc is another important one. I spoke about garlic yesterday. Garlic contains allicin. Allicin is so, so potent, but not when you fry it. Not when you fry it. You've got to crush the garlic clove, and what you've got in your hands now is the allicin, all right? So, you know, dress your salad with it. Obviously, after you've washed it for 20 seconds, and I keep sort of re-emphasizing, but, you know, it's that smell, that strong smell that you get from the garlic when you crush it is the allicin, and that is what's good for you, all right? So make sure that, you know, you're using garlic as well. Also, colloidal ionic silver. I like to use ionic silver. What silver does is silver sort of starves the bacteria and the viruses of sort of the oxygen, where, I mean, not all of them, unfortunately, sort of thrive on oxygen, but it starves can starve the bacteria or viruses of oxygen. So the colloidal silver is a really, really good thing to do. There's also, just going back to vitamin D, it also produces sort of a couple of other sort of chemicals as well that are exceptionally good for improving your immune system. All right, guys. So the other thing is olives. Now, so sort of olives are really good as well. Now, olive leaf is a product that you can buy in capsule form, and that has also been shown to be really good as well. Now, something that I just learned sort of just recently, and I've been using it, but certainly is in the press at the moment, is black seed oil. Black seed oil. Now, black seed oil has been used for centuries to sort of keep and boost your immune system. So I really encourage you to have a look at that. Now, most of these products you'll be able to get on Amazon. I really encourage you to sort of have a look at those and add them to your daily sort of routines and just try and eat healthy, but most importantly, stay positive, keep each other positive, and just know, right, this is my mantra from now on. And the important thing is that this too will pass. This too will pass, and it will, right? But we've got to work together, and we've got to stay positive and do everything we can to protect our bodies too, so that we can sort of come out of this even stronger than we are now, right? So thank you so much. I again appreciate your time, and obviously, if there are any comments, any questions, please sort of add them down. And obviously, you know, tell me, you know, I'm giving these videos and whatever, and I'm hoping that you're getting some information that's worthwhile to you. But, you know, I would much rather give you what you want. So, you know, let me know, what is it that you want? What kind of information are you looking for? And I will find out for you. God bless.